Hello dear students, how are you all? Hope you all are fine. You know, we all are passing through a tough situation nowadays. We have to defeat this situation with all our patience, positivity and maintaining the COVID rules. And I think soon we will overcome this situation and the situation will pass by. So now let's start our English language class. Today we will learn chapter 4. We have been friends together. It is from your workbook, Wind Chime 6. And you know, we already read and learned the poem. It is named as We Have Been Friends Together by Caroline Norton from the textbook Wind Chime. And here in the workbook we'll learn the vocabulary and grammar parts. Okay, so let us start. Here in vocabulary, here look, many words in English have been taken from other languages, you know. There are many words in English which is from other languages. The origins are from other languages. The languages are like French, German, Dutch and even Icelandic. So, here match these English words in column A to their root words in column B. Here are the English words and here are the root words. So, firstly, window. And you know what is the, it is window, you know what is window? Window is an opening in the wall or roof of a building or vehicle. It is to admit light or air and allow people to see outside. It is a meaning of window. And it is wind eye. That is window, wind eye. Okay. And so what is the root word of window? It is windu here. E. Windu. Just you, when you pronounce that windu and windu, it seems that they are sounds like same. So the root word of window is windu. Next is quiet. What is the meaning of quiet? Quiet means absence of noise, that is silence, calm. And here, look, the origin of quiet is here. Silence. Okay? Quiet means silence and here the original word is silence. Next, number 3 is here folk. You know, folk means common people actually. This word is used for common people and relating anything to the study of the common people. We use like this folk dance, folk song, etc. So, what is the origin of folk? That is vok, V-O-L-K, vok. Sounds like same, isn't it? Folk and vok. Next is number 4, boss. Boss is actually, boss is a person who is in charge of a group or organization, anything. Actually, boss is master. You can say that boss is same as master. To avoid the harshness of the word master, the word boss is used usually. And the original word of boss, origin of boss is here bus. B-A-A-S, bus. It also sounds like same. Next is
Number 5, cashew. You know what is cashew? Cashew is an edible kidney-shaped nut, rich in oil and protein, which is shelled and roasted before it can be eaten. We like, many of us like to eat cashew nuts. So what is the origin of cashew? Cashew, here, kazoo. You can see, kazoo. It is the cashew and kazoo. Sounds more or less same. Next is number 6, catamaran. Here, this is catamaran. Do you know what is the meaning of catamaran? Catamaran actually is a kind of sailing boat with twin parallel hulls that are held in place by a single deck. Kind of sailing boat actually, catamaran. And here it is catamaran, K-A-T-A-M-A-R-A-N. This is the origin. Okay, now number B, here, now use the internet to identify the language of the words in column B. So in column B, first of all, the word is silencers. Silencers, and the origin of silencers is, original word is from French. French is the language of France, you know. Next is the word bus. Next is number B, the word bus, B-A-A-S, bus. Bus is a Dutch word. The original language is Dutch. Dutch is a language of Netherlands. Next is the word in the C. C was cashew. Cashew is a Portuguese word actually. Portuguese is a language of Portugal. And next, D, catamaran. Catamaran is the original language is from Tamil. It is South Indian language, Tamil, you know. Next, E. Next, E was Vindu. Vindu is a Norwegian language. Norwegian is the language of Norway. And next is, lastly, Vok. V-O-L-K, Vok. Vok is a German. It is originally just from German. German is the language of Germany, you know. So, this was the original source of the words. Now, grammar part. Here is, underline the adjectives in these sentences. The instruction is, underline the adjectives in these sentences. Mention what kinds they are. There may be more than one adjective in some sentences. Now you know that there are many type of adjectives are describing words, and there are many type of adjectives. Here you can see qualitative adjective, demonstrative adjective, number adjective, quantitative adjective. And qualitative adjectives are brave, fast, dark, scary, etc. Demonstrative adjectives are this, that, these, those, etc. Quantitative adjectives, some, enough, little, any, etc. And number adjective, 5, 6, 100, any number. So, these are the types of adjectives. Okay. So, the first sentence, number 1. Those brave soldiers have earned great honor. Okay. So, here, those is
a adjective, an adjective. Those.
Those, it is
demonstrative adjective. And brave
and great, both are
qualitative adjective. Brave and great. Here are three adjectives. Those, brave,
great.
Okay.
Next, sentence two. There is little water in the tank.
So the adjective is little. Okay.
So little is quantitative adjective.
Next, it is sentence three. Sentence number three.
We crossed a lush green forest on our way. Here the adjective is lush green, which is the adjective for forest.
For forest, this describing word or adjective lush green is applicable, written here. Lush green.
So it is actually, what type of adjective it is? It is qualitative adjective.
You have to write here, okay, in the blank space. You have to write in the blank space the adjective lush green, and it is qualitative. Okay.
Next is number four. Almost 30 persons had come to attend that workshop.
So, which one is the adjective here? It is 30. What type of adjective it is? It is number adjective. So, you should write here 30 and number adjective. Okay.
Next number question, sentence number five. I wanted to eat some rice.
So what is the, which one is adjective here? Some. And the some is quantitative adjective. It describes the quantity of rice. So it is quantitative adjective. You have to write here sum and quantitative. Okay.
You know, sometimes in some sentences there are more than one adjectives. That means that there are more than one describing words. So there is a rule. When we use more than one adjective to describe a noun, we use them in a certain order. So, there is a certain order according to which we use more than one adjectives in one sentence to describe a noun. Here is a order. Here is the order. Firstly, quantity or number. Next is quality or opinion. Next is size. Next is age. Then color. Then proper adjective, then purpose. Okay, so this is the order. We should maintain the order. Now is the question. Rewrite these sentences by arranging the adjectives in the correct order. Make any other changes if necessary. Okay, so number one is, that is a new soft warm blanket. So, maintaining the order, we should write the sentences like that. We should rewrite the sentences like that. That is a soft warm new blanket. That is a soft warm new blanket. Next, sentence 2. Tina has long curly brown hair.
I think this is, the order is correct here. Tina has long curly brown hair.
So next 3. The Jacobs have an wooden old oval dining table. So the correct order is like that. The Jacob have an oval old wooden dining table. Oval old wooden dining table. Next, number four. Deepak likes to drink a dark, strong, sweet cup of coffee before he leaves home. And the correct order is Deepak likes to drink a strong, sweet, dark cup of coffee. Strong, sweet, dark cup of coffee before he leaves home. Next sentence is Kiran has a new electric expensive German guitar. Electric, expensive and German. These are the adjectives here. So, what is the correct order? Kiran has a new expensive German electric guitar. Kiran has a new expensive expensive German electric guitar. This is the correct order. Okay, so this was the chapter, and here is the extension. What do you think friends are important in our lives? In groups of four, perform a skit of friendship. You may show how friends help us to be better individuals and can make our lives not only happy but meaningful as well. Make sure that every member in your group has a role in the skit. It should not exceed 7 minutes. You may adapt an existing story or make up a new story to perform for the same. Okay, you can do it in your own, but it is not necessary. You can do it. And these are important here, as I told you. And you all write this words, rewrite these words and everything in your workbook. Okay, so this much for today's class. All stay safe until our next class. Bye.